KADI and
another public service announcement from KSHE.
She wants to get a picture of this, I think, Ellis. So if you get the... hey, call Aunt Mary. She ain't old enough for her to be Aunt Artie, is she? My goodness. Now, fine. Thank you a lot, Ellis.
Yes, sir.
Wish you a lot of luck.
Thank you. Nice talking to you.
Yeah, enjoyed it a lot.
It was a small station, and it's funny, there was no room for expansion. It was sandwiched between the back of a I think it was a Texaco service station and the fence, side fence of a drive-in movie theater.
It was on since 1960 as a classical station. There was a gentleman by the name of Ed Series who had this radio station in his basement, got those call letters, KSHE, and said, I've got an idea that I'm going to put together a radio station strictly for women. And it was all very classical. There was no rock and roll on the FM band. No. And then, Century Broadcasting bought it for a song, I might add, in November of 1967.
You gotta be one of the most beautiful people in the whole wide world. On the Johnny B. Goode Show, it's 10 minutes until 8 o'clock. Here's Bobby B. The Castaway Club will present the KSHE Discotheque Party. The KSHE Discotheque Party with a live broadcast from 3:30 to 6:30 at KSHE 95, direct from the Castaway 930 Airport Road. Free records, free prizes, and surprises with the KSHE Good Guys, starting Sunday, December 3rd. The KSHE Discotheque Party, send for your tickets today.
This is the Coco Sound of Johnny B. Goode, exclusively on KSHE 95.
We at KSHE. KSHE and St. Louis are not trying to do that impossible feat of pleasing all of the people all of the time. What we've set out to do, and what we are doing, is to offer a different kind of radio station to those in and around St. Louis.
I was hired by Ron Ells,
mm-hmm.
one of the most creative people who I ran into in my early days in radio.
Hmm.
Just a real creative fellow who changed this station, gradually changed it. Stations these days, of course, will do a very quick format change, but Ron gradually changed it from this background music station to what it became. We're probably playing Mottovani and the Ray Conniff Singers mm-hmm. and things like that. And Ron started to introduce, Simon and Garfunkel. And the next thing you knew, it was Jefferson Airplane. And then it was Cream.
It's 19 before 10. I'm KSHE, Radio Free St. Louis, with Sebastian Trepp. Ginger Baker on drums with Cream from London. This is White Room, 56 degrees at KSHE.
Tuesday, July 23rd, Umberto Orsini invites you to fly Jefferson Airplane. It will be the first day in the rest of your life. Jefferson Airplane will fly in Cool Keel Convention Hall for their first St. Louis appearance. You better find the sun. First, the Castaway will present Liberty Records' great group, The Hourglass. Then Friday, August 9th, at Cool Keel, Castaway Productions will bring you Big Brother and the Holding Company, The Iron Butterfly, The Ford Theater for Boston, Touch, The Truth, The Good Feel of the Aardvarks, and more. Tickets available now by mail.
It's 8 o'clock under St. Louis, the Brother Love program from KSHE Crestwood.
Well, I don't think that was true at all. It's 7 o'clock under St. Louis. Bob Seger's system.
The Brother Love program will not be heard this morning. KSHE's own Brother Love has left St. Louis and KSHE Radio. And this is my tribute to Brother Love, for whom I had very much respect as a DJ and a person.
He says, Gary, why don't you do what they do in San Francisco? And I said, what's that?
says they play sets. They pull two or three or four songs that maybe mean something or have a common bond or whatever, and put them all together and then talk after you're through. And I went, wow, what a concept.
To try to win one of these albums, you've got to draw a picture of what you think a Steve Miller Space Cowboy looks like.
This is Sir Edward sitting in for John Roberts on a Thursday evening.
A classic from KC95, where the hits just keep on coming at you 25 hours a day.
Jethro Tull. One of these days, they're going to catch on, and everything's going to be all right.
Brothers, put on your freakiest clothes, bring your festive goodies, and get down with 16 acts and 10 hours of music.
This beautiful slim pet is available in 12 brilliant high-fashion shades like Shocking Pink.
Whatever you do, don't forget to bring your festive goodies.
It's 2 minutes. Before 12 midnight under St. Louis, this is Don Corey from KSHE in Crestwood.
I mean, I can remember the very first Jimmy Buffett song I ever heard was Prince came in and played They Don't Dance Like Carmen Anymore. And he sat down and he goes, Eddie, you've got to hear this. And I go, wow, that's pretty cool. It's different, you know.
When I said, okay, Ted, give me a level. Ted start hooting and hollering. He just scared the heck out of me. I literally jumped up, banged my thighs underneath the control board. And it was painful.
Yeah.
My ears are ringing. He actually pinned the needle on one of our tape decks.
I see.
It's the married angle of it. It's like, and it's rock bottom, man.
And it's all come together. Sure. Yeah. Okay. I can dig it. It's a unique title. And we'll be looking forward to hearing some of that music at the Rainy Days.
For sure.
For sure, Ted. This Friday, Rainy Days, 14100 Olive Street Road. And thanks for talking with us.
Wasn't until the 70s, I should say, that I think it really began to explode, and all the music just came rushing in from all corners of the world, and there were people like me and you who just couldn't wait to get in there and expose it and play it.
Yeah, because I used to practically swallow the mic to get it down as low as I'd get it, and, you know, the tone and some of the emphasis and stuff was all put on, you know.
Providing a wide spectrum of progressive music from all over our planet. 95 FM. Rockin' stereo constantly. KSHE Radio. KSHE.
People remember pieces of them years and years later. It's kind of funny. That always kind of made me laugh. I'd say, yo, you're the guy that did the thing, and you know, providing a wide spectrum, that kind of stuff, you know. And remember that the promo, so it's kind of funny.
To find the ladder to the very top.
Yeah, and then put the little metal pail on the floor and piss in it, louder than shit.
And just the sight of, you know, your station manager, I think it was at the time. Birch handled it fairly well up until the very end. And I think he went to commercial or he went to music, but he brought the newscast to a very quick conclusion.
The Guess Who at the Ambassador Theater, June 4th and 5th. Tickets are $450, $550, and $650.
They did the show at the Ambassador, and I took them back to the roadway, and Burton Cummings, the keyboard player and singer, the drummer and the bass player, wanted to get a drink. So they said, come on, go with us. And they said, all right, so we went down to the lounge, and there were four or five people, you know, and the band had gotten done playing, and they had a couple drinks, and then they got up on stage. They said, hey, can we use your stuff? And they went, yeah, and they went up. And all I remember is they did like an unbelievably cool version of American Woman, a real jazzy version, a lot of keyboard.
In 1974, you were at the 7th KSHE birthday party.
Yeah.
Do you remember that at all? Yeah, yeah.
It was really kind of
unbelievable,
funny,
isn't it?
Yeah.
What a combination. They're still doing what they're doing. Holy cow, with a brand new album out and everything.
Jam 76 is Jefferson Starship, Fleetwood Mac, Jeff Beck, Ted Nugent, and Bob Seger together at Bush Memorial Stadium. Super Jam tickets are $10 in advance, $12.50 at the gate.
KC Glitter T-shirts exclusively from the two Looking Glass stores next to the Spectrum in Webster and next to Peaches in the Baldwin Plaza. What do you think about that, sweet meat?
Well, I guess I'm finally a star.
You're listening to the radio station. Progressive Rock, 24 hours a day in stereo. KSHE.
So he hears Ted say to Ron, "Hey, Ron, you hungry?" And Ron goes, "Sure." And he goes, "I'm going to go down to Subway and get some sandwiches. You want to come with me?" And here's Jimmy Mitchell under the console going, "Just a bleep, bleep, bleep minute. I'll come with you as soon as I get this bleep, bleep thing, bleep, bleep fixed." All this horrible cuss words, just, you know, a whole string of cuss words. So the next morning when I'm on the air, I answer the phone. The first person that calls, it came through my speakers loud and clear.
Friday, August 6th. Don't miss the power-packed, gut-busting rock of Van Halen.
Okay. What's that thing up there that revolving?
That's a tape.
Oh, a tape machine. From here, it looked like some strange... I don't know. I don't know what it looked like.
Well, it's certainly not a turntable.
And then when I started the Seeds program, well, there was just an outflowing of local musicians that, wow, to have the opportunity to be on the radio on KC.
Sure.
Holy cow. You know, they couldn't believe it.
KC was on a roll back in 1982. We were untouchable. Nobody could touch us. And we were picking our own music, and we were sounding good. And Rick Bayless was programming the radio station at that time, and he's great at what he does. And everybody, they just knew what their job was, and they did it well. And we had an all-star lineup at that time.
Keep your ring polished or let it tarnish naturally. Either way, it's your symbol of belonging to a unique group, St. Louis Rock and Rollers.
Sunday, March 13th, the Checkered Dome. Budweiser and Contemporary present Sammy Hagar. KC welcomes the Red Rocker, Sammy Hagar.
Yo, this is Red Rocker Sammy Hagar. Crank it up, St. Louis, because it's another rock and roll weekend on KC 95. Ow!
Hi, this is Ruth with another edition of KC Classics. Brought to you by The Disconnection.
Isn't disc jockey work fun? You'll have to excuse me. I got to get back to my show. But right now, here's someone who will... Just kidding. Actually, right now, I'm going to tell you how when you're a disc jockey, you get great money. Lots of money, prestige, top pay. But you'll have to excuse me. I got to go down and cash in some soda bottles so I can eat.
KSHE Crestwood, St. Louis. Let me get that legally correct, and I'm ready. Your Rich Dalton. Good morning. This is the Sunday Morning Classic Show, the show you remember after all these years on the station that we all grew up listening to, the station that saved our souls with rock and roll.
He said something to the effect that it's not the good songs that count. All stations play good songs. It's the bad ones that make the difference.
Yes, that's
Let's
right.
make every song count in KC's favor. Yeah. And I thought, what does he mean? Does he mean play bad songs? No, I didn't.
And I don't think that in all my tenure in rock radio that I ever saw anybody get so excited about music. He was extremely involved, and he'd do a dance if he heard a song that he really liked. I tell you, it was pure Shelley. There were many, many Shelleyisms that those of us who worked with him remembered, but that dance was certainly one of them. He'd get his arms close to his side with his hands out away from his sides, and he would spin those hands and shake his hips. Just, I'm telling you, you knew that he was just totally in love with a piece of music when he heard it. And he seldom picked
picked a song that wasn't really strong. Layla is one that comes to my mind.
Well, I felt that it had to have certain dynamics. It had to be fresh. It had to be innovative. The things that you looked for was a sound that you hadn't heard over and over again by other bands. And we would search for that type of sound.
And it was very emotional for us. We all grew up and came of age at Casey. Shelley was at the time about mid-40s, and he had all these guys, mostly guys, before Joy came along, all in their early 20s. And he had to manage them. And we were all, let's face it, we were all a bunch of beer-drinking, pot-smoking hippies playing records, enjoying, having the time of our lives and all this incredible freedom, doing something that anyone would love to do at that time of your life, you know. And he was trying to make it a business, and he was trying to instill that thought into us that this is a business, and there are certain things you have to do. And he taught us human relations and things like that. So we took everything very personally, and especially everything that went over the airwaves. And
I guess it was 8 years ago. So you did have him down, and I know he's listening today, and he's proud of this station as he always was.
Peace, love, pop, amor, shalom. Walk softly, drink lots of water, carry a big stick, and above all, say a kind word. Bye.
Well, I can see what you mean. It just takes me longer. And I can feel what you feel. Stronger. You can see.